Hi, let's talk about cardiac conduction. In this video, we'll discuss the locations of the major components of the conductive system of the heart. So the cardiac conduction system consists of specialized cardiomyocytes. Some people in their minds, they think of these as nerve fibers coursing through the heart, but they're just cardiac muscle cells. And recall that cardiac muscle tissue is autorhythmic, some areas more autorhythmic than others, and each area is going to have its own distinct rate. I'm not going to get into any depth of physiology here. I just want to relate to you the anatomical structures of where these cardiomyocytes are found so that you can visualize it as you do learn your physiology. So our story begins in the SA node, or the pacemaker region of the heart that has the highest rate or highest intrinsic rate of cells within the heart. This SA node is the region that the cardiac plexuses are going to work upon, so that would be extrinsic regulation of heart rate. That SA node is found at the superior portion of the crista terminalis, just subepicardially. So it's the myocardium that is just deep to the epicardium along that crista terminalis. Now, when we're talking about subepicardial, we should probably mention that the crista terminalis is the ridge on the inside. There's a sulcus terminalis that corresponds to that ridge on the outside. So from this SA node, depolarization will occur, and that depolarization will affect the AV node. The atrioventricular node is found at the nexus of the interatrial and atrioventricular septa, just adjacent to the opening of the coronary sinus. This is going to be the conduit between the myocardium superior to the fibrous skeleton of the heart and the myocardium inferior to the fibrous skeleton of the heart. Depolarizations from there will affect the atrioventricular bundle, which is at the superior margin of the muscular interventricular septum. That atrioventricular bundle, oftentimes called the bundle of His, branches into two bundle branches, a right and a left bundle branch, which are conducted along the margins of the muscular septum, of the interventricular septum. The lion's share of the right bundle branch, so I don't necessarily agree with this, goes through the septomarginal trabecula, and then the remainder is conducted down through the septum and around to the wall of the right ventricle. The left bundle branch follows a rather more parsimonious path around the left ventricular wall. And these are going to branch into Purkinje fibers, which will serve the myocardium of the ventricles. Now, any interruption of this pathway can lead to issues. Now, in particular, if we were to disrupt this region in here, that could lead to ventricular fibrillations or VFib, or if we were to take it out entirely, perhaps even cardiac arrest. You should keep this region in mind when you think about the anterior and posterior interventricular branches and their sources, whether that posterior interventricular branch comes from the LCA for a left dominant heart, the RCA, a right dominant heart, or a codominant heart involving both of these. So here is a closer view of the right atrium, and we can see that SA node at the superior rim of the crista terminalis. We can also see the AV node at the nexus of the interatrial septum and the atrioventricular septum, just adjacent to the opening of the coronary sinus. So we've discussed some of the major collections of specialized cardiomyocytes: the SA node, AV bundle, right and left bundle branches, and Purkinje fibers. This is your summary slide. Thank you for your time.